see actually today is it's an exciting time if you look at that. What we see is quite a bit of fragmentation in systems in the OSS and BSS area with satellite operators. Largely as a result of a lot of consolidation that has been going on. So an awful lot of tools, an awful lot of processes or a lack of processes end-to-end into the operations. A lack of visibility on the inventory at all times. So a lot of fragmentations is what we see today. And at the same time, I do see a lot of satellite operators looking to rationalize their operations. So that's a very nice thing happening today. Rationalizing means rationalizing processes in the organizations globally, but also rationalizing on the different tools in use across the different teams. Most often there's multiple network operation centers, there's help desk or service desks spread across the globe. So there's a trend right now with satellite operators to really get onto that and rationalize the whole OSS BSS infrastructure. Yeah. The best approach is to really consolidate everything into a single pane of glass. And that does not only count for Dataminr as a network management platform, but also counts for all the other tools. A lot of people, as I already mentioned, struggle with just having a view on inventory. A lot of people cannot schedule their resources effectively. I mean, satellite is expensive. Everybody is looking at efficiency gains in the modulation and transmission, but there's a lot of opportunity there just to use capacity more efficiently or effectively over time. So really creating that single view end-to-end across all the constellation, across all the bands, across all the ground stations is probably what is most important right now. That's the other challenge going on. As satellite operators also start to look into delivering new types of services, and it could be plain data connections, but increasingly, you probably heard that on the floor here, people are looking into new services like CDN type of services, OTT type of services. Most satellite operators cannot do all of that by their own and at the speed that they want. So they go out and have some services in the cloud, they rent capacity. Again, there, the single pane of glass remains important. And the single pane of glass, even if it's a part of the infrastructure that is not under control of the satellite operator, it's critical to still look at the handover points and really measure the performance of what's going out of the infrastructure and what's coming back in the infrastructure. So managing those quality levels, managing those SLAs is very important in the operations. Well, the first thing there is we don't need necessarily to have the best quality. So quality management, people, if I talk about quality management, people always think in the first place, I want to have the best possible quality. That's not at all the case. As an operator, as a service provider, you want to reach the target service quality. That can be good or better, whatever your business plan says. So measuring the quality that you achieve is very important. You do that by means of setting performance indicators, measuring those indicators and feeding that back into operations and also into the business. So that's the first thing. The other thing is the quality levels change over time as the business are changing. So the level of quality of a video or a broadband feed today may not necessarily be the optimal quality next year for the business. So being able to adjust those performance targets over time is also important, and that's what Dataminr can bring to you. So that level of visibility is extremely important. So yes, so we have in Dataminr the capability to support VNO type of operations. In a wholesale model, it could be megahertz or megabits or other services that are being sold. So we can create this environment where each of the end customers has its own, let's say, specific operational environment, its resource set service capabilities by itself. In terms of flexibility, we can indeed allow to each of the tenants of such an operation its own types of services and quality levels to that business. So I think that adds a lot of flexibility for operators to go into that type of multi-tenant business, retail business. So they can flexibly adjust what they sell. Yes, there's a lot of things happening in satellite. I already mentioned that a lot of people are looking into CDN type of overlay networks in addition to their DTH operations, OTT type of operations. OTT operations typically lean into cloud off-premises, initial deployments at least. So for us, there's a lot of things going on also for the satellite operators. We can speed up the whole process by being able to deploy new services very fast. So that's, I think that's living here on the show floor.